Shalom, shalom, and hello. This is Sister Victory. Blessings to my sisters and all who may be listening. Shalom and hello. I found this video. It kind of popped up in my feed, and it got my attention because it said the title was Seven Signs a Man is Sent from the Devil. Now, Lord knows we need some wisdom and discernment on men being sent from the devil. Because I'm telling you, I'm seeing this spirit out everywhere, even in the so-called churches or assemblies where people so-called call themselves following the Most High. People that practice polygyny, however it's pronounced. We see, oh Jesus, sisters, you better be careful. You better be careful messing with people's husbands. You know, just be careful. Just be careful because you could really be getting set up by Satan, you know. Because we got to remember, Satan only comes to kill, steal, and destroy. So you got to watch yourself, sisters. Don't be that desperate for a man that you just willing to put up with anything and deal with a wicked man. You know, the Father will bless you. He said, I will take care of the widows and the fatherless and the motherless. You ain't got to deal with no wicked man. Trust the Most High and get off your behind and work. That's what most people, if you got a healthy body, you're not disabled, you should be able to go get a job and work. Hallelujah. And do it with joy. Do something you enjoy doing, you know, that you feel good about. I know for me, it's helping people, you know, and Yahshua, he didn't go get a job being an executive boss. You know, he could have, he was a king. Okay. But he took a job, carpentry, something that will bring forth something to help people, building with his hands, you know, and he was building the spirits as well. Hallelujah. That's what he told the disciples. I'm going to teach you how to be fishermen of men, because they were fishermen. Everything we do is supposed to be as unto the Most High, as unto the Lord. So we're going to listen to a few of these things, sisters. And as we're listening to this, the link will be left at the bottom of the video so you can go look at it for yourself if you like to. But let's listen to some of the things this young man says. What women need to look for. And I see women fall for every day. And let me make something clear. Let me make this very clear, this disclaimer. Just because you're not interested in a man right now, sister, doesn't mean that you have to be with a woman. Because we know that's against the Most High. If, according to his scripture, it is. And if just because you don't want and desire to be with a man right now, because you don't see a godly man, a righteous, holy man, wait and hold out. You know what I'm saying? Hold out and wait on the Most High and follow him. Obey him. Hey, that's the best man I've ever found. I'm going to tell you, ain't nobody done me like Jesus. Ooh, hallelujah. That's the best man that has ever. No man can take care of me as good as the Most High. Hallelujah. And I'm grateful. But let's check out some of the things this young man is saying.
And they make you feel like when you're in minding your business, you're in your peace. They're just making you feel that they get triggered by you being at peace. Like it's a demonic spirit working through them. Okay. So you got to take heed to that. The unhealthy obsession. And when they're trying to force a friendship, relationship, and marriage into you.
Talking about a man.
For the woman, all right, is lures you in by materialism, okay? Remember, if Satan wants your soul, if Satan wants you to go on his side, he's going to give you things. He's going to offer you things. Even Satan tried to offer Christ, you know, if you come to me and bow down and worship me, I'll give you everything. So a woman, remember, a woman's more easily tempted than Adam, because the Bible says that Adam wasn't deceived, but the woman was deceived. It talks about that in 1 Timothy chapter 2. Verse 11 to 15, okay? So one thing about you sisters, you got to understand that the devil's going to try to lure you in with, you know, carnal objects, carnal things like materialism and you know, things that's pretty much just vanity, okay? So you have to use your discretion to understand. Now, there's nothing wrong with a man buying you things and stuff like that, so that's why you got to have discernment, okay? But One thing about an evil man, someone sent by the devil who wants your soul, who wants your possession, right? Because the Bible does say us chosen ones are a prized possession. So when the devil wants you, he's going to give you everything you want, material. And you're going to think that this is just too good to be true. And when something is too good to be true, it most likely 9 times out of 10, it is too good to be true. So always take heed to that.
Before he says number two, I'm going to say this, sisters. You have to realize that the word tells us when you lay with a man, you take on his spirit. So you, and this man, he'll say that in here. When you land with a wicked man, an unrighteous man, a foul, demonic man, whoo, Jesus, I would probably just throw up right there on the man. If I land with some, oh, Jesus, help me. I can't. Once I learn, maybe, you know, and men deceive us. They pretend, some men will pretend and make you think he's so wonderful and he's this great guy. You know, he sound like he love the Lord, and you fall into that trap. But you know, let's be honest, because I've done it. I'm not going to sit up here and lie. I'm so tired of lies. I don't know what to do. I heard that still voice in the back of my mind said, no. He ain't it. Nope, this ain't right. Nope, leave him alone. Nope, run the other way. And yet, because I might not want it to be alone, I'm tired of doing it by myself. Oh, he's going to buy this for me. He's going to pay for this before me. He's going to put a roof over my head. Whatever. But I still heard that voice to say it. Run the other way. Leave him alone. And I didn't listen. And every single time I pay for it, I pay for it. We don't have time to keep letting people play with our soul salvation. We at the end. We too far in the race to turn back. Keep letting people turn us back. I'm going to play this again, and it will be a link at the bottom. But let's go on and listen. Sisters, you need to learn. Every time a man run up on you and brush up on you, don't be so desperate to just every man to try to want to lay with you or be with you. Say no. If you got the Holy Spirit and you know you hear that voice and say, leave this man alone, he ain't right. Start obeying that voice to tell you to run, and obeying the Most High, you will have less issues and problems. Let's finish listening.
Number three, this is very key. You women gotta take notes, man. Okay, so the number three sign is he has no desire to get married or to have babies. It's a warmonger. And unfortunately, the woman of the world today, she attracts these type of men. And the Bible says that a wicked woman is given over to a wicked man. So if you're always attracting these type of men, that must mean there's something that's in you that's attracting the same spirit that's attracting that type of person, okay? Now, if you just attract it one time, that's different. But you seem to always attract men who just want to pump and dump you and never want to actually take you serious and, you know, build with you.
Here. I have a treat for you to try.
The number three sign is he has no desire to get married or to have babies. It's a warmonger. And unfortunately, the woman of the world today, she attracts these type of men. And the Bible says that a wicked woman is given over to a wicked man. So if you're always attracting these type of men, that must mean there's something that's in you that's attracting the same spirit that's attracting that type of person, okay? Now, if you just attract it one time, that's different. But you seem to always attract men who just want to pump and dump you and never want to actually take you serious and, you know, build with you and start a family. It's because, remember, the Bible says a wicked woman is given over to a wicked man. That's why it's very important to have accountability. There's something that's in you that's attracting the same spirit that's attracting that type of person, okay? Now, if you just attract it one time, that's different. But you seem to always attract men who just want to pump and dump you and never want to actually take you serious and, you know, build with you and start a family. It's because, remember, the Bible says a wicked woman is given over to a wicked man. That's why it's very important to have accountability. And when I attracted these devils and these agents my way, I never blame them or point the finger at them. No, I blame myself because they didn't put a gun to my head and say, you have to get with me. You have to date me. You have to be a friend. No, I made the conscious decision to be friends with them, and I reap what I sowed, you know, because God always shows us, guys. He always shows us, especially if you call yourself a chosen one. He shows you who people are. Okay.
Like many of you, people, you are shown who people are. And yet you still go along with them. You still keep friends with them. you still roll with them knowing exactly who they are. Women, you lay with these men. And it's, I really see it in women who are practicing polygamy. I may not have it right because I don't live that way. That's no different than, I'm going to be honest, I found messing with the men in the streets had more honor than I see in these polygamy or polygynous relationships. They had more honor for the woman. But it still wasn't right. It's not right. Adultery is not right. Fornication is not right, according to the scriptures. So sisters, you see the man is lustful. You see that the man is lustful. And you allow him to lure you in with material things, money, you know, whatever it may be. Some women like to lay with men just because they carry a title. Now you the worst kind. You really need help. You want to lay with a man because he carries, maybe his title is a pastor, an elder, or a president of a CEO of a company. Some of you ain't even getting nothing out of it, but you with a man with a title. You know you broken, sister, when you do this. You need the Most High to help you. When you lay with men because you desire to lay with a man because they carry a title, really search yourself. You need some deliverance. Bad. And I don't even know if there's any help for you, because at least a woman that's desiring a man for material things, she can go get a job and take care of that herself. But for you who are excited about a title, someone else's title, you feel like you got to be with a man with a title. For what? You need to be delivered, sister. I'm telling you, I've been a broken sister. I'm not dogging you out because I know where I came from. But I'm going to give a scripture because I always like to give what the word says. This is what the word say about some of these wicked men. That you sisters have to be wicked to keep going along with it. Titus 1, oh Jesus, and 14 and 16 is what I'm going to read. I've already prayed. So I'm going to read Titus out of the New KJV. Okay, the NKJV Bible is what I'm reading out of in the Titus. Chapter 1 of Titus, verses 14 through 16. And it says, not giving heed to Jewish fables and commandments of men who turn from the truth. 15 says, to the pure, all things are pure, but to those who are defiled and unbelieving, nothing is pure. But even their mind and conscience are defiled. 16 says, they profess to know God, but in works they deny him, being abominable, disobedient, and disqualified for every good work. Sisters, leave them men alone that has no good works. And I'm not talking about just physical works, because we know the Bible talks about that. I'm talking about good works in their heart and their mind. Leave them alone. It ain't worth it. At the end, you're going to be by yourself, left, and you done just gave your cookies to somebody who's undeserving. You done just cast your pearls among swine, to swine. Just remember that. Let's finish listening to this young man.
Knows you. And when you disobey him, when you're disobedient to his commandments and the Holy Spirit warning you, you're going to reap what you sow. And it's very key to take accountability, okay? Accountability. Stop blaming other people and blame yourself, okay? So when a man has no desires to wife you up, okay? He just wants to just pump and dump you, and, you know, he's dealing with other women, and he's lying and being deceitful about it, and he's telling you he's monogamous. You know, as the Bible calls it, a warmonger, and warmongers will not inherit the kingdom of God. So you around here align your spirit with a warmonger, okay? You're going to go down there with him, okay? So always keep that in mind, all right? The number four sign is after you sleep with them, okay? Ooh, this is deep. Oh, man, y'all better take heed, man. Ooh, after you sleep with them, you will notice feelings of demonic energy and you start to feel yourself drifting away from God. You start to find yourself more into sin, okay? And remember, the Bible says that the woman is a weaker vessel. What does that mean? It means that, okay, so the woman came out of Adam's rib, okay? So that means woman compared to a man is more weaker, so she's more prone to being deceived, more prone to being, you know, fall into the snares of the devil, okay? This is why it's important to have a woman to have a head in her life. Now, if she doesn't have a husband, you got to have a Christ in your life, okay? And you got to also understand.
Now, we're going to have to hear that again, sister, just in case some of y'all missed it. I'm going to do a replay on that. Lying and women that's in polygyny really got to be careful. You really need to be careful. Really need to be careful, sisters. I'm telling you, we really need to be careful. I know back in the day, if I was to have laid with every man that wanted to lay with me, I would never got up to be able to do nothing else. So, sisters, don't be so desperate. I don't know. I know some sisters might not have gotten a lot of attention from men. And so maybe that's why any little attention a man gives you, you just, oh my goodness, you just so happy that you don't know what to do with it. You know, and part of it is you're broken. Most women that's broken and allow men to mistreat them, we didn't have a father figure in our life. And if we had a father figure, he wasn't good. It wasn't good. He wasn't the example to us to show us that we are loving, gentle creatures that need to be loved, that need to be held, that need to be encouraged, lifted up, made to feel good about ourselves. So when a man comes along and sound like he or make us think he's caring anything about us, we don't know how to handle that. So all while your heart is looking for love, admiration, appreciation, that man had one thing on his mind. And we fall for it because we want to continue to get that so-called love and admiration and attention. So, you know, be careful though, sister. This is what Yahshua came for us. Everything that have defiled us, has broken us, have destroyed us, he wants us to be healed from everything, from the end. Not just, I think we think that Yah just on the Most High only want us healed from physical diseases and sicknesses. Not so. He wants us to be healed in every single areas of our lives. I'm going to let this play. And then for a little while, the video will have a link at the bottom to listen to for yourselves, sisters. So here we go.
Shows us, especially if you call yourself a chosen one, he shows you who people are. Okay, he shows you. And when you disobey him, when you're disobedient to his commandments and the Holy Spirit warning you, you're going to reap what you sow. And it's very key to take accountability, okay? Accountability. Stop blaming other people and blame yourself, okay? So when a man has no desires to wife you up, okay? He just wants to just pump and dump you and, you know, he's dealing with other women and he's lying and being deceitful about it and he's telling you he's monogamous, you know, as the Bible calls it a warmonger, and warmongers will not inherit the kingdom of God. So you around here align your spirit with a warmonger, okay? You're going to go down there with him, okay? So always keep that in mind, all right? The number four sign is after you sleep with them, okay? Ooh, this is deep. Oh, man, y'all better take heed, man. Ooh, after you sleep with them, you will notice feelings of demonic energy and you start to feel yourself drift away from God. You start to find yourself more into sin, okay? And remember, the Bible says that the woman is a weaker vessel. What does that mean? It means that, okay, so the woman came out of Adam's rib, okay? So that means woman compared to a man is more weaker, so she's more prone to being deceived, more prone to being, you know, fall into the snares of the devil, okay? This is why it's important to have a woman to have a head in her life. Now, if she doesn't have a husband, you got to have a Christ in your life, okay? And you got to also understand that when you're out here having, you know, you're out here fornicating with a whole bunch of dudes, right? You're now going to carry on those spirits. It's called soul ties, okay? And you out here, you don't know, you ever been with a, some of you sisters can relate. Now, I'm not a woman, so I can't relate to this, but some of y'all know you slept with a certain man, and then you start to feel like the demonic presence within you is because his spirit is now in your spirit, okay? This is real. That's what the Bible says to flee fornication, and you're sinning against your own body, okay? So always keep that in mind that, you know, after you sleep with somebody, you start to feel yourself start to drift away from God, okay? Those demons that are in him is going to now be in you, too. You're out here fornicating with a whole bunch of dudes, right? You're now going to carry on those spirits. It's called soul ties, okay? And you out here you don't know, you know, you ever been with some of you sisters can relate. Now, I'm not a woman, so I can't relate to this, but some of y'all know you slept with a certain man, and then you start to feel like the demonic presence within you is because his spirit is now in your spirit, okay? This is real. That's what the Bible says to flee fornication, and you're sinning against your own body, okay? So always keep that in mind that, you know, after you sleep with somebody, you start to feel yourself start to drift away from God. Okay, those demons that are in him is going to now be in you too. You know, you ever been with some of you sisters can relate. Now, I'm not a woman, so I can't relate to this. But some of y'all know you slept with a certain man, and then you start to feel like the demonic presence within you is because his spirit is now in your spirit. Okay, this is real. That's what the Bible says to flee fornication, and you're sinning against your own body. Okay, so always keep that in mind. That, you know, after you sleep with somebody, you start to feel yourself start to drift away from God. Okay, those demons that are in him is going to now be in you too. That, you know, after you sleep with somebody, you start to feel yourself start to drift away from God. Okay, those demons that are in him is going to now be in you too. This is deep, bro. This is a spiritual warfare, okay? Always make sure before you rush into a relationship or to sleep with a man, you got to make sure you align yourself spiritually and make sure that man is following the Most High. Because anyone, this is for a man or a woman, anyone who's not following God, okay, not following the truth, that means they're following lies. That means they're following the devil, okay? Always keep that in mind. If you want a relationship, a marriage that's a strong foundation, you got to make sure that man or that woman is following Christ, is following, you know, the Most High, okay? I'm not a woman, so I can't relate to this, but some of y'all know you slept with a certain man, and then you start to feel like the demonic presence within you is because his spirit is now in your spirit, okay? This is real. That's what the Bible says to flee fornication, and you're sinning against your own body, okay? So always keep that in mind that, you know, after you sleep with somebody, you start to feel yourself start to drift away from God, okay? Those demons that are in him is going to now be in you too. This is deep, bro. This is a spiritual warfare, okay? Always make sure before you rush into a relationship or to sleep with a man, you got to make sure you align yourself spiritually and make sure that man is following the Most High. Because anyone, this is for a man or a woman, anyone who's not following God, okay, not following the truth, that means they're following lies. That means they're following the devil, okay? Always keep that in mind. If you want anyone who's not following God, okay, not following the truth, that means they're following lies. That means they're following the devil, okay? Always keep that in mind. If you want a relationship, a marriage that's a strong foundation, you got to make sure that man or that woman is following Christ, is following, you know, the Most High. Okay, it's called soul ties. You're aligning your soul with all these men. Okay, you're gonna have those demons, and you have many demons in you. Okay, and just like that man had those demons in it, now I'll just jump into you. Because all right, number five.
So there you have it. You know. Women, you especially you women that practice polygyny, that left one man and jumping with another one, be careful. Be careful. And this is why I can see, so this explained to me very well why so many of my sisters are jacked up from the men that they slept with. And I know I've heard men say, you know, it's the opposite. It's the woman with all DNA in her. But who, how much, who, Jesus, you got to realize we as women are receivers. The man is the giver. So sister, be careful when you got a man giving you all his wickedness. Joshua 24 and 14 says, I'm sorry, Joshua 24 and 15 says, and if it seems evil to you to serve the Lord, choose for yourselves this day whom you will serve, whether the gods which your father served that were on the other side of the river, or the gods of the Amorites in whose land you dwell. But as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. And I'm saying, sisters, as for me and my legs, I shall keep them closed.